Hey guys, so today is actually not bad. It's 60 some degrees, so it's pretty warm. And I'm just out here trying to get into more into this book. So guys, James Baldwin. Now, initially picked this book up last month, but I was reading another book with it, and then I quickly realized that this is just not that kind of book you can read with another book. So I end up having to put this down, and then when I did pick it up back, I was like 60 something pages and I had to reread it. So now I'm pretty deep in, so I'm gonna definitely finish this in this reading vlog. But what I'm gonna tell you, out of all of this, is the fifth book I've read from him, and this is probably the most complicated because of the characters that he created in this story. And we have what we call friends, these group of guys who typically hang out at a juke joint and in New York, and they have this bit of a complicated relationship with each other, where some are genuine friends and some are have this jealousy issue, and are some just look at them as like not really a friend but maybe like an associate. But they all have individual issues, and in this case you have only one in the group is black, and he's struggling with a whole lot of things. It's just so many things that for this particular character that is just so complicated and also sad, and it does show the side of mental health in this story. And then you have the other characters where you're getting bits and pieces of their personality and things that's happening. But it covers race, it covers sexuality, it covers career, it covers family as well, and even interracial dating, it covers that. But if you dice, you know, this, what's the word I'm looking for? If you really dissect this story, it really can come on with a lot of discussion and a lot of things you can like talk about. It also is the time period, you know, that this book was set in, where it was, you have this racial issues that even in a friendship where it's interracial, one party may never understand the struggle of the other. Not because they don't want to, but because it's just not something that they understand. They look at it as we're friends, and you shouldn't have a problem with that because we're friends. That part, but it also who you love, you know, is a major factor as well, and who you, especially that time period where, you know, being in an interracial relationship, or even your sexuality and the lifestyle that you live might dictate a lot of things that you do and how you feel. I'm really enjoying this. I also feel like I find myself at times stopping to really soak in what was said and what's happening with that character, because it's not really cut and dry. He really you know, packed a lot in this story that it's not an easy read. It's definitely not an easy read. It's definitely nothing like the other books that he actually that I actually read from him, which were, you know, also had deep stuff, but to me it was more, it was completely set on the table, versus this is you have to really understand why certain characters were doing what they were doing. So I'm gonna continue this, and maybe be at the end I can really do a review that is like completely makes sense, because like I said, this book is not cut and dry. It's just it really is packing on so many emotions and things that's happening with these characters. So yeah, so that's what I'm gonna do, and then I have to do my, you know, journal entry for the day. And hopefully I can continue, because there are people playing music, there are people doing house work and yard work, and you know, my neighbors are out enjoying and taking advantage of their quarantine life. So yeah, Hey guys, so I have been having one of those days, guys, where I am catching up on some sleep. I'm so happy to be off this weekend, and I am going to sleep, probably read some more tomorrow, pick up something new. But I'm going to just go ahead and give you the wrap up of Jane's Baldwin. Now, this is the fifth, and I would say for the other four books that I read from him, they were all strongly surround family. Versus this one is mainly a friendship situation. So in this group of men, I would say it touched on, you know, their sexuality. It touched interracial dating. It touches on career. It touches on things that made the story juicy, made it gossipy. It is wild. But it also, to me, give like a slight take of what some friendship may have possibly been back then. You know, this is the late 50s, beginning of the 60s, and it's New York City. Although it was in the South, it still had a history of a racial tension. And when you have one black character and everyone else is white, and the emotional distress that's going on there, and each not understanding it, it does give that interesting element to the story where you can understand how that's possible. And you know, adding some interracial relationship in the mix of all of that even complicate the situation even more. It was very gripping, raw, and unfortunately there were moments where it was extremely sad. But he did a thing in this where I feel like for the time period that this was publishing, it was very ambitious to write a story where you have multiple characters who are bisexual, and how sex is used more of like kind of a drug, like that emotional high you need in that moment to deal with whatever is going on. And your views on love, what it means to be in love with a person, what it means to be in a healthy relationship with a person. And that whole idea of finding yourself and regrets and possibilities of towards the future when you're still not, haven't accepted your involvement or your possible things that you could have possibly done differently, that you're still struggling with in order to get ahead. Now, in this story, there are two interracial dating, and the one that you, in the beginning, you don't really get to know a lot of what caused the issue in that relationship, but the second one, you get to see it. You know, this black woman who I felt often was portrayed as the angry black woman, which is, I think, maybe purposely done in a way where it's easy to see how in a circle of group like this, and being a black woman and having to express how you feel about certain things. A surprise thing that I didn't realize is how much it was thought of, if a black woman is with a white guy, most likely she's a whore. You know, it's not possible for a white man to love or be in love with a black woman. That was interesting in this. But I did like her having a voice and saying stuff and making sure that her feelings are being heard. But you can see that it was portrayed in more of an aggressive way to the white guy, who is a bit clueless. And I don't think he was being mean or not wanting to understand. I just think it went over his head a few times, of some of the things that she was mentioning. There's characters in this who I felt were more of a metaphor in how they were used, because they were the go-to person in times of sexual desire, which was interesting as hell, wild. I was reading this thinking, you ever read a book and things are happening and you kind of feel like you just want to put them all in the bath and wash them down and throw some holy water? Don't come for me, guys.
Now, I do like books that are a bit wild and just out the box and different. But it made me, this book made me look at Baldwin in a way where I'm like, this man was a freak. Sorry, guys. But I love him. I love him. I just think, you know, if you could write a book and be creative and have some strong views and things you want people to ponder over, and then throw some freaking shit in there, go ahead, Bowen. Go ahead. I was here for it. Pick it up. The less you know, the better the experience of this book. It is very good. I enjoyed it. I still have things that I am not sure about that I would love to have a discussion about. And his writing, still amazing. His ending, still the same formula of how he ends his story, where you want to dig a little deeper and want to know and want to maybe just interpret it, what possible could have happened after, because there's some things that's just not completely tied up that is give you the whole idea of that's life. So yeah, but pick it up, guys. I mean, he's amazing, and this is another good one to add to the list, and I can't wait to dive into another Baldwin. But for right now, I'm going to end this video and take my butt back to sleep. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, guys, and have a good day.